Would you like to support Cubs Out Loud? One way is to join us over on Patreon. For as little as a buck a month, patrons get early access to our shows, the pre and post show, and various other rewards. You can learn more at patreon.com/cubsoutloud. Thanks to all of our patrons for their support in making this podcast. January 15th, 2023. I'm Jeff.
Who's your bear? That's right. I am your bear.
I'm Damon.
I don't brew the tea. I just serve it.
And that makes me Gary.
Everyone else is thinking it, and I just say it.
And welcome to the Cubs Out Loud, the bear podcast of indeterminate length, episode number 679. This one was going to be 680. We went over that two weeks ago. So, hey. What do you know? And also, we've had that exact same theme song for 15 years. Gary?
Segway?
I thought that's where you were going to put in applause. But then there was no applause. It's like, okay, maybe we're not happy about that.
Thank you. Okay.
Just a reminder, folks, while we have been doing this for a long time, we are not mind readers still. We don't always we can't always catch the cues. I knew it was a segue.
Well, Gary guessed or had thought appropriately that maybe that would be a place to put the crowd applause thing. So I didn't think about that. He was smarter.
Well, the crowd was tepid. They were waiting for the cue card. That was the issue. So, like, the crew member kind of fumbled. Yes, that's where things went sideways.
Danica!
Damn it, Eric! I told you. Fix the damn sign. I don't know.
Yes. So, many moons ago, a cub had an idea about getting some people together and just kind of recording their thoughts on dang near everything and anything.
A 27-year-old cub, I think it was? Yeah, 27.
Wow.
And decided to call it Cubs Out Loud.
After listening to a tech podcast for the longest time called Buzz Out Loud, the CNET's podcast of indeterminate length.
Are they still around?
No.
Oh, okay. We outlasted them. Yay. But since then, 678 sequential episodes have been produced, two generations of hosts, thousands of hours of listening and watching some guys yammer about, and over 450 videos on YouTube. So, yeah. It's an anniversary show, kids.
Yay!
Woo-hoo!
Happy anniversary. Woo.
So I know this is going to seem a little strange because we're not doing anything extra special other than like recognizing we've reached 15 years. So for those of you that are kind of newer to the podcast and don't know, January 17th, 2008, Cubs Out Loud was birthed. I have no idea if it was painful or enjoyable, if there was an epidural or anything. I wasn't around then.
Were drugs involved, Jeff?
No. Alcohol.
It was natural. No doula or midwife involved. Yeah. So, going back to the beginning, my biggest question, Jeff, is did you have any concept of a longevity, like in terms of I'm going to do this thing and it might fill in the blank, like it might last a year, it might last 10 years, it might last 1,000 episodes, like was any of that a good concept? I mean, most people I think of our age that started things a while ago might not think that. I think people who start things now might make goals, like a million views or, you know, just metrics.
I was listening to podcasts and I was like, I want to do a podcast. And so I asked a couple of my friends at the time, hey, would you like to do a podcast? And they said, sure. And despite the fact that we all lived in the same city, I thought, hey, probably the simplest thing is I'm going to figure out some software and then we'll just do it via Skype. Even though
okay.
I'm in the same city.
And so I will say this.
Like, this is something I want to do. I had no aspirations for anything.
I think that's fair. I will say this, since you were kind of mentioning about like being in the same city and using Skype. So Skype has always been the backbone of the show since the beginning.
Yeah, pretty much for the call at least.
Right. The platform that allows us to talk to each other. So what I find interesting about that is you were like, well, we all lived in the same city, but why would we want to see each other in person? What a silly concept. Like,
well,
you stay
it,
over
it
there,
wasn't,
I stay here.
It wasn't really necessarily that. It was logistics. It's like, hey, I'm not making a lot of money or anything, so I can't do any investments. You know, my partner died about a year ago. So it's not like I'm a two-income household or anything. Because if he was around, he would probably be my perpetual co-host in all this. Who knows? If I even would have thought of this if he hadn't passed. In fact, I don't even know if I'd be in Austin. I don't know what would have happened. I was like, for 15 years ago.
Right.
And so I'm like, logistically speaking, what's the easiest way? Well, I got a game computer. I've got a Mac. I know a lot of people use Mac for podcasts. I did a little like searching around. I was like, oh, there's this program called Ubercaster. And like, ooh, this is cool. Yeah. Oh, okay. I think I could do this. And then hooked it up and the rest was pretty much history. We even like we actually did some streaming at one point in time using Ustream when we were recording back in the first generation.
So I think it makes sense, like for those that like now maybe think about doing podcasting, the landscape has changed so much in a decade and a half. There are entire platform business industry things built to make that possible. When you started it, and then eventually, I think when Damon and I came along later, a lot of that really wasn't existing. Some had started coming along, but I think now, because it's considered a viable career slash income like way of living thing, you know, that people think like, oh well, you know, you just do this thing, you visit this site and you sign up and like they take, you know, pennies of your dollars or whatever and they do right. all this stuff, whatever. But this has always been kind of a homegrown operation, and if you're not necessarily aware of that, I don't know how you wouldn't, because this is not the most professional of podcasts. And that's
never
slam.
Right, professionals. Like let's get that out there right now. So yes, FYI for everyone listening, we don't get paid, nor do we get a whole lot of revenue from, say, the ways we put things out there, right? Like right. we're on YouTube, yes. We've got a lot of videos on YouTube, but we're not monetized on YouTube.
We don't have enough subscribers.
Right.
And like it's a combination of like number of subscribers, number of viewers.
Yeah.
Patreon. I mean, you see our Patreons that they every day. What they really just help with is, hey, there are expenses for this, and that really helps out with that. And sometimes we try to find ways to upgrade our equipment a little bit. But in the end, it's not enough to really make a bigger.
Right.
Push in improving the podcast and all, so but that's okay. You know why? Because we're really just doing this for fun, for the most part, or at least that's what I'm doing. I don't know about you guys.
Well, that brings up a good question. Well, if I wanted to be cheeky about it, I say the reason I do it is I can blame Damon.
Fuck you. Every time. Not going to let that go, are you?
Nope. But I'm just saying, just because I did another podcast, didn't mean automatically that I needed to do this one. And so for those of you that don't know the story in the audience, there is a mutual acquaintance slash friend of Damon and I, Mr. William Brown, who had a podcast, I think, called The Inappropriate Couch, if I remember. And it was based in the bear community, but it had some crossover. It had some very eclectic and colorful guests. And it was fun, but the big thing was that he did them in some people's homes, but he tended to do some of them at events. And so I had done a live taping, I guess.
Yes.
Recording.
What do we call it? Recording? Yeah.
Recording.
At Midwest Bear Fest in Indianapolis, Indiana, many moons ago. And Damon, for some reason, I don't know what was happening in his little, mind over there of various gears and wheels, but he was like, oh, this dude likes familiar with a podcast thing, and we're looking to possibly expand hosts. Mm-hmm. So I got a message email. It was like, hey, would you like to come on?
Mm-hmm.
It's like, sure. So. Yeah.
Right, we can interview you about a drenched fur.
Right.
And we're like, hey, guess what? That really wasn't just an interview. That was an interview for joining the show.
Yes. That one was, if I remember correctly, that was January. I don't know why my mouse is being strange all of a sudden, which is very annoying.
Did it break down as well?
Girl, really? One moment. There we go. Apparently there was dust at the optical lens. Yes, I'm using a kind of a retro Logitech mouse, apparently. So we're coming up pretty quick on my 10-year anniversary. January 20th is when I was originally on the podcast. So that's kind of one of the milestones. So you kind of reached out and I was like, sure, whatever. And I had sort of listened before, but not quite really engaged in being a regular listener. And that was merely because I was already listening to other podcasts. And you were the only one that I knew, Damon, that was a host on it. So I was kind of like, oh, okay, cool, whatever. But that was an interesting thing. I mean, before that, in speaking of milestones, January 25th of 2010, just about 2 years out, the podcast hit 125 episodes. No, 100 episodes.
Mm-hmm.
And in first generation classic modeling, the name of that episode is Boy Butter Makes the Cookie Last Longer.
Oh,
yeah. We had some interesting
these
titles.
Days.
Mm-hmm. We did have some interesting titles in the days.
I also remember the difficulty of coming up with titles when we recorded an episode without really a focus. And it was like, what are we going to call this?
Well, I have to say that a lot of the early ones really didn't have like a focus, plan, topic, or anything like that. It was all just kind of like bullshit. Any ideas what you want to talk about today? Yeah, and just a bunch of jokes, and especially the titles were just based off of what happened in the podcast. What are we going to call this show?
And then there was a break. There was a lapse for a little bit of time, which I think is kind of bound to happen. When you create something and you're putting it out into the world, unless you have a whole like kind of plan laid out before you thing, and you just kind of let things happen, then that can be challenging if you're not like thinking in terms of like contingency and stuff. And it's not that you have to, but that's happened, you know, sometimes there's several podcasts I have in my feed that they just kind of went away. Like they didn't announce that they were ending. Some have, but they just kind of go away. And there's a desperate part of me that's thinking maybe one day they'll come back.
Someday.
I know. It's kind of silly.
Or not.
In that case. So there was a little hiatus, roughly about, I think it's 8 months-ish, something like that. No. Let me see. The math is hard. 7 plus 2.5. So like 9.5 months, not quite 10 months. And then we get to the immemorial date of March 4, 2012. And yes, as Damon is like referencing to our Cubs Out Loud 10-year anniversary shirt, the next generation is really what that's recognizing. So March 4th of 2012, Damon is thrust upon the scene and joins several other people. I don't quite recall off the top of my head, Jeff, who all was in the original Next Gen. Was it just a...
Okay, the very first episode, it was me, Damon, and Ben.
Right. Just the three of you.
Mm-hmm. Just the three of us. And oh then... Robert, I don't remember if we if I did a solo one for Robert or...
Yes. Okay, you did a solo one for Robert, and then Robert joined us, I think, either the episode, next episode or episode after that.
Yeah, it was his, like, audition.
Mm-hmm. Nice. Interesting. And then it expanded. I think we added Eric.
Mm-hmm.
And then I think I was the last of kind of that got added within that year.
Yes.
Ish. Something like that. So yeah. And then we just trucked along for quite a while. And then, we got to 250 episodes on March 2nd of 2014.
Nice.
And we just kind of keep doing it.
Yeah.
Over and over and over and over again. And it's more about just, you know, kind of putting things out there and cranking them out. And then we get to March 3rd of 2019, and it's the 500th episode.
Yeah.
And I know that we've discussed this before. I'd have to do a quick check. I'm not sure if we're the longest standing bear-based, like bear community-based podcast at this point. Maybe.
Maybe. It's possible.
I'm pretty sure we have beaten out Bear Podcast.
They got to 600. I just pulled up their website. It still exists. Rayonard wrapped up at 600 as their final episode.
Wow.
So, yes, we have surpassed them. Now, they did do another podcast very briefly afterwards, and I can't remember what they called it. It's kind of
I think it was something like about being geeks or something like that. Some geeky thing.
Yes, I think so. So, yeah, they went for quite a long time, and I think there's nobody else that I can think of offhand. I mean, there's Movie Bears.
Mm-hmm.
But they're newer.
Right. And they do more frequency of shows, if I am correct about that. So they may have more episodes, but I'm not sure. Let me double check. I'm going over to their website at moviebearspodcast.com. Ding. Cast. Okay, y'all like
talking amongst yourselves.
What's that?
Talking amongst yourselves, because you said y'all, and I'm like talking amongst yourselves.
Well, you know, listen on the web. I'm trying to navigate their website really fast. You think I would have done this sooner? They just had
in their 10th anniversary.
Congrats, guys! Way to go! Last month they celebrated 10 years. We're celebrating 15.
Look at that.
Yeah, I think they're doing approximately weekly.
Okay.
So, because it's like 10, 7, or 12, 17, 12, 10, 12, 4.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And I think that's one of the things that we found over the years. Because it is a hobby and we're just trying to do it for fun, for enjoyment purposes. Right. It takes a lot of time and effort. And as Damon and I have discovered in the offshoot Cubs Out Loud drag race, doing two episodes a week, the regular show and the drag race one for months upon months upon months, it's very taxing.
It can take a lot.
Yeah.
And I just know, I know one of the things for sure for me has been, you know, we've been doing this for a while, and I think the best thing is that we, you know, we're doing it because we like doing it and we're having fun doing it. And we've had some, you know, highs and lows. I will do the obligatory that thing, but we've kind of kept it going. And hearing, oh yeah, we're 15 years and oh, we're one of the longest, if not the longest, you know, bear podcast out there, is a thing to kind of be proud of in a sense. It's funny, the chorus has been mentioning, because we're in our 32nd season, the CMC, the men's chorus, and we are one of the longest running LGBT plus organizations in the city of Cincinnati. And again, it's something to, longevity is a thing to kind of be, I don't want to say be respected, but it's a thing to be like lauded and applauded in a sense, in a way. So 15 years, you know, and to be blunt, the cornerstone of all of it is Jeff.
Right. Because honestly, if you decided to just pack it up one day, Jeff, Damon and I wouldn't be doing this. I don't know what we'd be doing.
I mean, if it was something where I'm like, look, I give up here, I'd be like handing stuff to you guys if you wanted it. If not, it would be like, oh, we're shutting down then, I guess.
Yeah. And it's funny that you said, Jeff, that you were 27 at the time, because you are now, what, 40?
What's 27 plus 15?
Right.
Yeah. 42. Yeah. But it's just, it's interesting just thinking about that. Cause think about it. I think we can all kind of have that conversation about ourselves. Where were we 15 or 10, or more years ago? And where are we now? And just being like, wow, that's kind of.
Well, that is the interesting thing, because I was talking with my best friend who was recently visiting and staying with me, and we were talking about the history, like how long the podcast has been around. And I mentioned that coming up on the 15 year anniversary, and they're like, wow. And then they're like, wait, you haven't been doing it since the beginning. And I was like, no, I came on later. And then I was trying to remember whether or not I did any episodes not living here. And I didn't. So like my 10 year anniversary is just coming up in a couple of days. And I was like, okay, like I had just been here, not even a full year yet. And it's funny because I was thinking about like the things that have changed. Jeff, I think you've moved once, twice.
Twice, I think.
Yeah. And maybe, Damon maybe had an apartment.
Maybe two and a half, because I did move apartments in the same complex.
That's true. So yeah.
Got it.
And Damon had that apartment,
right,
in Cincinnati. And I have been here, but like this is flipped. Like my office where I'm sitting now used to be my bedroom, and my bedroom was like used to be the office. So I think about those things just kind of like in a look back factor of like how things have changed. But you're right, Damon. Like, you know, who was I 10 years ago? You know, and what was I doing at that time in my life and the experiences that we've had? So yeah, there's been a lot of stuff.
Has been a lot
over that, you know, time frame. And honestly, I had no idea when coming on, what it was going to involve, or what it was, you know, what any of that was going to be.
Yeah.
And I never thought about it in terms of like a longevity project or this would personify me. But it is ironic to think there have been two significant things in my lifetime that have kind of molded me, or like are chapters of my life that I cannot ignore. Cubs Out Loud is one of them. Being involved with the Berg Bears in Pittsburgh, PA was another one. Mm-hmm. I came to them in the fall of 99 and was with them for, golly, 13 years, 14 years.
Right.
So, and I went all the way from being just like a general member to being on the executive board to eventually being president. So yeah, it's interesting. I was just thinking, oh, the only other thing that technically is longer than these two things is the Pride Picnic. that we do here in the summer, because I've been involved with that probably 16 years it'll be this year, I think, or something like that. It's been a long time. But that's a little different. That's a one-off event. Drench Fur I did for, 15 plus years. It's been a thing to see what these, parts of your life are. And I don't know how many people have those that they can look back on and recognize outside of a job. Yeah. Maybe if they stay anywhere.
Yeah. It was funny. One of the things I'm getting involved in literally this month is another podcast, more D&D related, or game related. But I was introducing myself on that show, and they kind of asked you, like, do you have anything you want to, like, anything you're doing, any projects, anything you want to spiel? And I was like, well, the first thing, the obvious thing, is Talk Out Loud, because it's another podcast that I do. Not safe for work, definitely not safe for work, but it's a podcast that I do that I am, proud to be a part of. You think about it and you're like, wow, yeah, I've been doing this for over 10 years. I think I'm on, when you said 2000 something was when, you know what? I have it in my calendar somewhere.
When you joined? You joined in 2012. So you're coming up on 11 years this March.
I thought so, or something like that. So, when you think about that, you go, oh, wow, like 10, 11 years now, this has been kind of a big thing. Like, the chorus has been a big thing for me. I'm actually approaching 20 years for that next year. So it's just like you said, there are these very significant life, moments and things that you do. And it's great to have these, I don't want to call them signposts or tent poles or whatever. Like
milestones?
Milestones. That's the word. There you go. Yeah, they're milestones. And it's rather interesting to me that one of my milestones is always going to be this show. I actually have it saved on, I was going to go to my calendar because I have it on my calendar because I don't want to forget it. And no matter, March 4th, 2012, right there. No matter what, I don't want to forget it. So it is a repeating indefinitely on my calendar, my Google calendar, as a reminder of just how long and what I've been doing. I have a few other things that I could say are those milestones for me. And when I think about it, as Gary was kind of saying, this is one of the main ones.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And I think that, like you were saying before, Damon, that there is something to be, I think recognition is definitely a piece of something that has longevity, whether it be a nonprofit or a business or, something that people do. And it is interesting because I was just paying attention on Twitter. I think some people were putting up postings and they were kind of doing retrospective, look backs. And I found that interesting because they were posting about things like, they're mostly artists and they're like, this is something I did 10 years ago or whatever. And I can see the evolution of what they've done in that time frame.
Right. Exactly.
So I think the same thing has happened here with us at the podcast. We've had this, transition and change. We've had, various hosts. We've changed up the format. Like I kind of made, reference to kind of jokingly about the early years. For the longest time, podcast episodes were just randomly named. And of course, in my typical type A fashion, I found that challenging. So I was like, hey, what if we do this? So in about 2014, I started offering up the idea that we themed episodes and started creating series. And now it feels like every God Blessed episode is by Christmas. just saying. We started, roughly 8 years ago-ish, 2014, with stuff. We started doing this, that, or others. although we didn't call them TTOs at the time, we didn't know that was going to become a thing. For some reason, I must have seen the writing on the wall, and there's an original show, episode number 253, that is only called Let's Talk About Sex. Which is funny to think about it now, because now it's a whole series. And then 2 weeks later, we had Hadrian and Jeff Rockrub on, and we talked about blowjobs, and we did Let's Talk About Sex Blowjobs. back in those days. Yeah. So, and it's turned into a whole kind of thing that we've done over all these years. So, yeah, I think
we became more organized.
Yeah, I mean, and I don't think there was ever, I've never had any personal intentions of like, oh, this is going to be like, you know, huge, and it's going to be our jobs, and it's going to be an income. Like, I never thought of it in terms of like us turning into the Try Guys or anything, you know, right. As a random example. Like, it was, you know, and we're still open to ideas, you know, as far as topics and things. Like, we got a listener submission recently that I sent an email about, which reminds me, I should double check and see if they replied, because I actually offered for them to come on to be a guest. Because honestly, you know, like, the guests over the years, part of it has been, do we know them directly or not? Do we have a connection or an affiliation with them in some fashion?
Right.
Because that makes it easier to have a conversation about the podcast and for them to be on. If they've never been on a podcast or, you know what one is, that could, you know, kind of be challenging. So, yeah, it doesn't look like we've had a response, but that's okay. Yeah. So we'll see if they want to come on or not, you know, in that case. But yeah, it's interesting to see how that developed. But it was like, oh, let's, you know, have guests on and let's, you know, randomly talk about various topics. And then we did a couple of on the road shows and, you know, the infamous Indianapolis Midwest Bear Fest, where I got this bug up my rear end and we went and got fucking insomnia cookies and like fed people and gave them drinks and, you know, the atrium. And...
oh, that was a fun time. We went Facebook Live for that one.
We did. We did, with alcohol in us. you know, it's one of those things that I kind of look back with fondness on. And who knows, like, that might happen again. I mean, we had the best of intentions. COVID. And go to, you know, one of the international bear events, quote unquote. And then, unfortunately, I ended up getting COVID, so, you know, we still tried to have a podcast and record something. That was an interesting experience.
Right.
To say the least. So, yeah. There's just been a lot of stuff over the years. But I'm very happy that we've reached a milestone. I'm proud of it. I think that this is something that we should all have, like, some ownership in terms of, like, I guess pride is the only way to really phrase it, you know, yeah. And the effort and the work that we've done. You know, I didn't imagine this was going to be a thing that I would do for this length of time. But then again, like, I don't know if anybody ever considers that in their life, you know, like, oh, I'm going to do this thing outside of maybe a relationship.
Right.
You might think to yourself, like, oh, I'm going to grow old with this one. I'm going to, you know, watch them age and gray and lose their hearing. I'd be crazy, you know.
Yeah, true that. Like, the I think when we were talking about doing this, like, way back in the day, on what Bear Bruiser
was it Bear Book at the time, or did it had
it was Bruiser at that point. When I joined, it was Bruiser. It was originally Bear Book, but it became Bruiser.
Oh, okay.
And when I joined and saw the post from Jeff, like, hey, I'm looking for people to, you know, potentially co-host a podcast. And I was like, oh, sure. Like, let's give it a shot. Let's see what happens.
Why not? You know,
why not? You know, what the fuck? Like, I like to talk. I like, you know.
Oh, yeah. And, yeah, we know.
Yeah. Yep.
You really gave the subtitle of podcast been German link.
Run for his money. Yep, sure fucking did. But I fuck you, Bo.
I mean,
I know it's the truth, but I can swallow my own tea. Wait, nope. Anyway, the idea, when you know this came about, I was like, sure, let's do it, and we'll see how it goes. And it wasn't a long-term goal of mine,
mm-hmm.
you know, kind of like what Gary was saying. But over the years, it's part of my schedule. It's something I do now. It's on my Sundays. It's what I do, you know.
It's a little ironic to me, Damon, because I've done this now for almost a decade, and a fair amount of people who are close to me know that I do this, but I still get every once in a while, they're like, when do you do that? And I'm like, Sunday.
Oh, you know that, like, day that I don't schedule anything on because I know I have to do this thing? Yeah, that's the day.
Yeah.
But I mean, it's been surreal in a ways, because I, you know, we've gone from it just being audio, right, to now audio and video. We've grown to have a Patreon, mm-hmm. Where we have. Now, we're not like, you know, big time, like we keep saying, we're not big time. We're not big there. We're not out there like getting all the bucks and doing all the things. But we are able to, through the Patreon, sustain and
we're not
make
trying
smaller
that
improvement. Yeah. But we're also, I agree. We're also not doing, we're not doing anything major to build, like, to make it like this extreme thing. I think we enjoy what we're doing. We have fun. Our listeners enjoy what they're hearing. And I think that's all that we can really ask for.
Right. Well, and there's little things about what we do, I think, that we don't realize. So, like, as an instance, like, this person that wrote in was like, they listened to an episode from quite a while ago, actually. And I was like, wow, somebody went back and listened to that far. I found that kind of interesting that they listened to an episode like over 100 episodes ago, which means it's like over 2 years old. Not that you can't do that. Like, y'all, if any of you are kind of newer, you are welcome to go back and listen to, you know, the first generation of episodes.
When are available.
Yes. Well, the pandemonium of those of the early points. And the reason that Jeff says that is, unfortunately, along the way, some episodes did get lost in about, what is it, year three-ish? In 2010, like, we know of their existence, what their titles were, but unfortunately,
I was using a different hosting service at that time, and that went under, and I hadn't re-downloaded everything to archive them, but now we have a much more reliable podcast host.
Mm.
It's called archive.org, and thanks to all the people who donate to archive.org to keep that thing going.
Nice.
Yeah, and I think that'll be an interesting thing for the future. Sometimes I wonder, like, I wonder what future society will think of this, you know, when they come across these things. I think about that, like, Chicago with the Leather Archives and Museum. In Chicago, there's actually a couple different things. There is an archiving of, like, gay publications. So the local gay newsletter that is celebrating 30 years that I'm on the editorial board for, they have been submitting copies. Like, that was a project they did a couple years ago to try to find physical copies or digital copies of everything that ever was done under their flagship, and then submit them as digital copies so that they would be, you know, held and archived there. And that's incredibly helpful because sometimes you're trying to remember things in a timeline. You're like, wait, when did, who did that? And blah, blah, blah. You know, like we were having this recent discussion, like as a sidebar, we're doing a community spotlight article series this year. And so we're like looking back to try to remember when certain things happened in time. And if it wasn't for that already existing, we wouldn't have anything to look back on. We'd have failing human brains. We'd be like, wait, who did what, when? Like, you
know. Right.
So, yeah. That kind of stuff. But, yeah, and then we're wrapping – well, not wrapping, but this – well, very soon, March of this year will be the conclusion of our fifth year of Patreon, which is ironic to think about because I'm pretty sure – I talked about Patreon a year or 2 years before we even launched. I purely was like, hey, what do we think about, you know, asking people to, you know, kind of subscribe, quote unquote, with a dollar or two, just as a thing. And the biggest thing was like for the first 10 years, Jeff paid out of pocket for everything that was an expense of that sort. And so now, at least with Patreon, every 2 years, the money that we have that comes in allows us to pay for domain hosting and that kind of jazz, you know, which isn't oodles of dollars. It doesn't have a comma in it, but still it's money. Mm-hmm. And that's the thing I think people don't know if they're not really in the web industry. They don't realize how pricey it can get to have a website and to, you know, have services because there's domain and then there's hosting and then there's periphery stuff that goes with it. So, yeah, it can. Could be a whole thing. It ain't free in that case. So that's where it's like, hey, so we started the Patreon for as little as a dollar a month or more. You get stuff. And I know that we haven't been the best in terms of like, you know, delivering on the rewards, so to speak. But we're coming up on our anniversary. So some folks are going to be getting some things, including new shirts. So, yeah. And I realized we might actually do some 15th anniversary stuff now that I'm thinking about it. So yeah, fun things. So any thoughts towards the future? Classic interview question. What comes next?
Hate that question in an interview.
Where do you think you will be in 5 years?
Oh God, I hate that question so bad. I hate it so much. It's the worst interview question.
Well, if I'm really lucky, I'll be face first in daddy's lap and I will be extracting DNA.
I'm interested in DNA extraction. What do you mean by that?
Well, I think you understand.
What is, well, what, why do people do that? Why do people, okay, it's total sidebar. Why do people that are only listening, they don't understand what's happening. David just did this whole thing where you like wipe your mouth, but then he act like he flicked away the good stuff. And I'm like, what are you doing?
No, it's wipe and lick. Or
Yeah.
Every drop, anyways. See, that's the stuff. That's the content that I think some people get, you know, they long for. Mm-hmm. The double entendre and the perverse, and you know.
So, future, I think I like, there's a part of me that would love to grow, but I don't know what I mean by that, if that makes sense.
Okay.
Like, what does growth mean for this podcast? That's kind of where my mind goes. Like, do we want, you know, more listeners? Do we, I mean, yes, but like, is that the way I mean by growth? Or do I mean like expanding what we do? You know, there's a part of me that wants obviously more listeners, you know, bigger picture on people coming and supporting us and what have you. But I can't tell people and force people to do things.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like, so I think, from a podcast standpoint, I would like us to, in the future, kind of still be here. You know, we've come up with a really good formula that works in a sense, that allows us to do this thing that we enjoy and have fun doing, and keeps us, you know, and keep doing that, you know. Beyond that, I can't think of much more.
Just keep on keeping on.
Well, right. I will say this, and I don't, I realize this might be kind of triggering or button pushing or whatever. I don't know if the original format would have sustained.
Well, it didn't.
Well, what I mean is, like, I don't know of many podcasts that exist that are random. And by random, I mean, like, it could be everything and anything. I think we've really developed. I think the whole industry has definitely gone into it. Like, there's a focus. There's a drive. There's a whatever. And so, like, we do that. And I know that we don't talk about the most timely of things, which is very ironic, given how we recently tried to talk about something that was, like, you know, a hot button issue. See episode 676 about where do we go next, which was about Twitter. And no sooner than we recorded that damn episode, like, shit changed, which was ironic to me because I was like, see, this is why sometimes it's challenging.
Better to just wait, to sit and back and wait.
Well, right, to discuss hot topic, you know, the current thing. And yet at the same time, I can imagine some people, you know, might be thinking, like, why don't you guys talk about this or talk about that? And it's like, well, I think there's a time and a place to figure those things out. So, but yeah, I mean, I think personally, I would like to see us continue on with some of the things that we've done. I'm very incredibly grateful to Dr. Ed, Dr. Angelini Cook, for taking us on the journey of, like, them pursuing getting their PhD and joining us regularly with Landscape of Relationships. Like, that was totally not something planned. Mm-hmm. I think I'll just say this. Most of the things on this podcast aren't planned. bit spontaneous.
Not very far in advance, at least.
No, not at all. But, like, I think with him, I have to go back and look, when we kind of started that, I think that grew out of him coming on for Let's Talk About Sex, if I remember correctly, back during the pandemic, maybe? No. Maybe that's when it started, was during right before the pandemic. I'm, like, live searching. This goes to show how well planned this was. So in November of 2019 was the very first Landscape of Relationships. And I remember, like, it was like, oh, this is a thing, but this is, like, a bigger thing. Like just talking about this is a concept. It was like it was not a one-er. Like, there was no way in one episode we were going to be able to discuss it. And then I was kind of like, hey, like, do you want to revisit? And Ed was like, sure. And then all it's turned into is, like, topic after topic after topic, like, expanding this whole kind of, like, mini universe of the concept of what is a relationship and what are things that people can think of. And I'm really proud of that for us, because I hope that, you know, as we continue it on, and then maybe, you know, if there's some day where we exhaust all the topics, you know, people will be able to look at it as, like, a whole series or playlist and be able to glean things out of it and make their lives and the lives of the people that they interact with better, because they learn about, you know, key important things about, like, communication. I mean, we've talked about what jealousy and boundaries and rules and sorry, I just am laughing at some of this stuff. That was not I was tripped up by orgasm versus ejaculation. That is not a Landscape of Relationship. That's a Let's Talk About Sex. Just like, 591. But yeah, like, we talked about trust, and apologizing, forgiveness, and I really appreciate that Ed's, like, you know, giving us really insightful perspectives about things. Like, I catch recently, some of us are still talking about love languages, even though we did an episode about that. And we kind of learned that love languages is complicated in its history, like anything that actually exists. So,
right.
Yeah, that was 636 for those that are interested to figure out what I'm trying to not say, but say. Anyways.
When a guy who's a douche comes up with something that actually makes sense. It's good.
Well, I mean, we've talked about that before. The whole which one was that one? Pedestal? I don't remember which episode that was. Where we kind of discussed about, you know, we look up to people and then they turn out to be jerks, you know, or assholes or whatever. Yeah. Mm-hmm. All tea, no shade, September of 2020, pedestal to cancel. We talked about people that, you know, when we were younger or young adults or whatever, we looked up to certain people and then you're like, ooh, you're a Nazi? The fuck?
What episode was that one?
That was episode 571. That was in the midst of the pandemic. Yeah. So I'm looking forward to seeing what things are. Actually, I need to correct the record. Apparently, we did get a reply email within 24 hours of when I reached out to somebody. I just didn't see the email. So my apologies to them. I'll be touching base with them. So most likely we will be having a guest on soon to visit a topic we've covered before, which I'm excited about because I like the idea of revisiting things because shit changes over time. Right. And it's not always necessarily the same.
Like we said, you know, we've been doing this for 10 plus years. The show has been 15 years old. There are probably thoughts and opinions and feelings that we had even 5 years or 2 years ago that are different now based on recent, you know, growth and maturity and education and knowledge and introspection, et cetera.
Yeah. Which is kind of one of the things is we have definitely changed over the years too, because I remember saying some things early in the years and then later on in the years, I had a very different viewpoint of it because I changed.
Well, right. And I was going to say, like, sometimes when we do flashbacks, I legitimately listen to the whole flashback episode and just try to pay attention because sometimes, woo howdy, there are opinions expressed or statements made and you're like, well, that didn't age well. So I might put a little disclaimer. Preface, yeah, in front of it and just be like,
by the way, this was like years ago. These were the feelings expressed at that time. It may not be the current feelings expressed by the people or opinions of the person at this time.
Right. Well, and that's what's kind of ironic. And looking back is always, I think, a lesson in perspective. To be like, I was how old then? Or this is where I was in my life? Or this is, you know, these things that were happening. Right. You know, and not that we defend ourselves, but it was like, well, the hope would be that, you know, people would grow, that they would evolve. Right. I saw an interesting tweet shared recently just today where a woman was saying that she hopes that cancel culture just comes to an end. And I found that interesting because her perspective was cancel culture has robbed the concept of someone being held accountable because now we've turned it into a whole thing where we're canceling somebody and it's like, we're not engaging with them. Like we're not having a conversation. We're not trying to address things with them and say, do you understand? Would you like to understand why there is a difference of opinion about this or whatever? And I found that really interesting as a statement. I was like, I hadn't really thought about that.
Right.
So, yeah. And then there is a second guest that has been sort of multiple months in the planning. By that, I mean, I reached out to them and was like, hey, would you love to be on the podcast? I think you bring an interesting perspective. And I'm looking forward to re-engaging with them because they had kind of a personal big project thing that was going to happen. And now that their life has kind of settled because they had some changes significantly to that. So I'm looking forward to we're probably going to have at least two guests in the coming months to be on. So, yeah, it'll be nice. But if you are all listening and are watching have ideas for topics or of interest or other things, let us know by, you know, all means. And we'll see what we can do to make it happen when it comes to that stuff. Any other final thoughts as we get ready to wrap?
I can think of. We didn't get our statistics all set up. Sorry about anybody was excited about that, but hey, Sometimes we get lazier as we get older.
I'm amused because I'm like, oh, wow, those blank numbers of people who were so wanting to hear all the
our most stats. Viewed video made this year was.
Yeah. It's okay.
I'm sure we're fine.
Everything's I'm pretty sure fine. It's still Hadrian.
Yeah. Anyways.
Just saying.
Where's my thing? Get the right tab up. That's it. Okay. Well, that's the end. Anyways, contact us. Pop over to our website, cubsoutloud.com. Still going on. It's cubsoutloud.com. I've had that for over 15 years. You can shoot us an email at cubsoutloud@gmail.com or leave this voicemail at 361-COL-TALK. That's 361-265-8255. You can follow us on Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube at Cubs Out Loud in the appropriate place of the URL. You can join our Entourage chat on Telegram at tinyurl.com/telegram-col. And if you want to see when we're planning or recording these shows, you can check out our Google Calendar at tinyurl.com/calendar-col. You get various accoutrements, such as a Consent is My Foreplay shirt. And I don't think that shirt's available on the website. Yeah. But the hat is... The mugs, the handy towel, all at zazzle.com/cubsoutloud. In fact, there was a streamer on Twitch, twitch.tv/nerdybear_90, newly affiliated cubby podcaster or streamer, who is actually wearing that shirt right now. No, or actually, did he take that off? Yeah, I made him take it off.
Habba.
Well, I redeemed some of the beer paws. Anyways.
God.
Anyway, some of these designs were designed by Smashy. You can find more of his work at tpublic.com/smashythebear. You can become a patron at patreon.com/cubsoutloud, or if you want to send us a donation, you can do that at paypal.me/cubsoutloud. You can find us on pretty much any podcasting platform, Apple Podcasts, Google Play, Spotify, Amazon Audible. And please rate us and review this there. The more people, the more your raters review us, the higher in the algorithm we get, the more people will find us. You can find me anywhere on the internet as box.boxpuppyboxcubbox, something or other. Damon.
If you wish to get in touch with me, you can find me as TheaterCub79. That's TheaterCub79. 79 on most bear related sites are on Facebook and Discord. Or you can find me as pup_umbra on Twitter. The Twitter is definitely not safe for work.
If you would like to get in touch with me, you can pretty much just search for Garbear73 online. That's GARBEAR73. I've joined some random new social media sites. I'm not going to list them all, but you can try that or Garbear73XXX, depending on if it's the pervy one. And just as a point of clarification, I think some people, I'm disappointing them because I'm not putting myself out there. I'm just like posting or reblogging other people's
It's thirst Twitter.
Yes. Yeah. I don't have the self-confidence at this time. Maybe that will change in 23. We'll see.
Right. Yeah. I have some stuff out there. I have some pictures out there. They're on my Twitter.
Recordings out there.
Yeah, I have some recordings out there.
Yeah, so do I. And with that, say goodnight, everybody.
Good night, everybody.
Ciao for now.